Contrasting video of you sitting the trot with stirrups, because you don't sit like this when you have your stirrups on, okay? So you're going to bend them left, you need to shorten up your reins, and you're just going to keep your tush in the saddle, and you're going to ask him to canter. You know he has a beautiful canter, he's just going to carry you. Good. And you just sit back. Now is that to die for or what? Try to let the legs hang down, not grip with the knee, and the seat needs to go forward and back. Right, so the seat scoops the saddle like an ice cream, scooping ice cream. Somebody used that once, so. Okay, so now you're gonna sit tall and T-R-O-T. So you sit into his back, rhythm on the bit, bending, half halting, make the circle bigger, inside leg, little outside rein, little tap, try to drop the knee, bring the leg down and back. And of course we would like prettier transitions, canter to trot, but you know, it was a nice canter. So you're gonna go ahead, drop the knee. So you canter, you sort of think, slide the inside seat bone forward, keeping them on the bit, yep. When the inside seat bone swings forward, the outside leg comes back. Do you know why that would be, Pilates teacher? Because the pelvis is one big, huge bone. So when you swing your inside seat bone forward, which is connected to your pelvis, your outside leg naturally goes back. So we'd like to get them more in the bridle. Yeah, and when you ask them to go in the bridle, your inside leg might have to say go up to the bit, and that's okay. Get them back in the bridle, and now you're gonna sit tall and ask them to W-A-L-K. Good, and you can take your stirrups.